God to root out every besetting sin from your life. Every besetting sin. Every sin that will not allow you go. Ask God to take away every weight. Ask Him to cleanse you. Ask God to help you. To live a life that is well pleasing in His sight. Thou shalt the Savior from heaven. Warn my desire from morning to evil. There is a road that each day you must follow. Humble yourself to walk with God. Could you humble yourself tonight and say, Lord, sanctify me? Do you want God to use you in the music ministry? You want God to use you in a pastoral ministry? You want God to use you in an evangelistic ministry? You want God to use you in an apostolic ministry? Do you even want God to use you as a politician? Can you ask God, purge me. Help me to love righteousness. Help me to hate iniquity with passion. If any man purge himself, he shall be a vessel unto honor, meet for the master's use. Ask God to uproot every seed of unrighteousness from your life. Every besetting sin, I say, Lord, go for the roots. Go for the root. Let it be rooted out. Let it be rooted out. Are you having a problem with opposite sex? Are you having a problem with the love of money? Ask God, let it be uprooted from my soul. Pray that you be in such a manner as it is meet for the master. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Listen. Open your eyes. If you study your Bible very well, you will see that that is a pattern. God insisted that before the Levite can enter the sanctuary, they must be cleansed of all iniquity. And if a Levite should enter the sanctuary without being cleansed, they will carry him out a dead man. So they normally tie rope on their leg. As the rope, there will be a bell ringing. As he's entering the sanctuary, the bell is ringing. Because in case God found any impurity in his life, in the Holy of Holy, will be struck dead immediately. And the only way to carry me out is by drawing the rope. Do you know that as powerful as Samson was, when iniquity was found in his life, he became a beggar. His eyes was removed in the wilderness. The enemy could not conquer the Israelites until they introduce iniquity into their life. What was the iniquity? You know what Balaam said? He said, these people, you cannot conquer them. The sand of the king is in their midst. He said, but if you want to conquer them by all means, just look for beautiful girls. Moabite girls. Send them into their midst. Then they will. And that was what happened in the book of Numbers, chapter 23. Moabite girls. The Judeanans. Oh, you don't know the meaning of Judeana? I didn't say Juliana. What do I call them? As they enter, they were just doing like this. They are just doing like this. I see they were turning okra inside the pot. Then the children of Israel saw them, say, ah! This is women, choo-choo. They started sleeping with them. And in 1 minute, how many thousands of them died? Thousands of them were slaughtered. I was touched by the testimony of an army colonel who fought Biafra War. I was invited to preach in a ministry a few months back. and the man was to commission a group of theologians who have just finished Bible school. And he said, look, as a soldier, you must not entangle yourself with filial fear. Sit down before we take the final prayer point. He said, don't entangle yourself with filial fear. When I got home, I told my wife the story. The man said, I was a soldier. I know what it means to be a soldier. And I know what it means to be to get involved in civilian affair. So he said, let me tell you from my experience. He said, I was the leader of the battalion that was sent to conquer a part of the east. He said, two of us were sent, two battalions. He was leading one, another soldier, another colonel was leading another one. Said, we were told to go different directions, but meet at a point. So they were going. The first one went. When the first colonel entered into the village, the Biafrans have sensed that they were coming. So the Biafran soldiers said, we heard that Nigerian soldiers are coming. And they have heavy equipment. We may not be able to withstand them. What are we going to do? And the Biafra army took a decision. They said, what we are going to do is that we are going to move away from the town and we will ask our women and our children to engage them. Then they said, how shall they engage them? Say, we tell all the women to strip themselves naked. So all the women in the village strip themselves naked. When the first battalion came, they saw beautiful women. You know, in the east, so many of their ladies are very light in complexion. The ones that were very light were the ones in front. They were doing like this. So the soldiers, some of them, their Mr. Man rose, their body became weak. They threw down their gun and started sleeping with those guys. They were sleeping with them. As they were doing it, the Biafran soldier came from the bush and killed all of them without exception. They finished that team of Nigerian soldiers. So he said he didn't know what has happened there. But he was a very strict army officer and disciplined army officer. He said he doesn't compromise discipline in warfare. So as they were coming, they got into the village. They find many of Nigerian soldiers killed right on the ground. This same set of women welcome their team again. And then he said, they were looking at Oga. Oga was not looking at anybody. Oga was looking at enemies to kill. Looking for enemies to kill. So by the time the Biafran soldier came the second time to meet his team, they thought they were already on the floor. They find that they were not dead. That's how they won that battle. They finished them. And he said he only lost only three soldiers from his team in that battle. But that other person lost all, including his own life. Do you know in ministry there are no-go area? Iniquity is a no-go area. Ask that God will create love, hatred for sin in your heart. Ask God, Lord, create hatred. It's a creation of God that from now onward I will hate it with passion. You begin to pray that from this moment you will hate sin with passion and you will love righteousness with passion. That no matter what somebody will do for you, you will say, no, I cannot betray this trust. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Our Father and our God, we are grateful to you for the mercy you have had on us. Thank you for the many years of your dealings that has helped us to discover your pattern for a biblical ministry. We pray that what we are learning tonight, this morning, will not be for keep. Let it become an operational principle for our life, that we may love righteousness with passion and hate iniquity with passion. Love is all that the Bible says, because he loved righteousness and hate iniquity, the Lord is God anointed him all of goodness above his mates. So we ask you that Lord, the anointing over our life not be polluted by unrighteousness in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, our Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We want to thank the Lord.